I'm going to show you how to do a crackle with latex paint. And your base color can be any type of color you want. It can be eggshell sheen or satin sheen, or you can also use one of Modern Master's metallic paint collection colors. I just have a gray-green here on my surface that's on in a satin sheen. And I've got a piece of tape down because I'm going to show you two different methods of applying the top coat of paint. And what I'm going to use is Modern Master's crackle for latex paint. And once your base coat on your surface is dry, you can roll on a coat of the crackle. You don't have to roll this on, you can also brush it on. But you want to get a nice, good, even coat of the crackle. Now it's a clear medium, and nothing's going to happen yet until you get your top coat of paint. You just roll this on. Nice and even. And now we have to let that dry, and then it's ready to put the top coat of latex paint on. Okay, now the crackle medium is dry. It's ready for the top coat of latex paint. But there's a couple of things you need to know about the top coat. First of all, it has to be latex and water-based, and it should be a flat paint. Flat paint cracks much better than any paint with a sheen to it. Also, when you're working on vertical surfaces, there is a risk of the paint sagging, so you need to apply the paint quite thinly. It's also much better to apply this technique to smaller areas if you're doing perhaps cabinetry, doors, baseboards, or furniture. So the crackle is dry, and I'm going to put my latex paint on now. I'm going to show you a couple of techniques of applying it. I'm going to roll it on. And then we're going to brush it on. So I'm going to load up the roller first. I don't want to have too much on the roller, because if I get too much paint on there, there is a risk of it sagging. Now, this cracks almost immediately, so you can't do too many back rolls or back brushes. You just want to keep it going. If you over-manipulate the crackle, you're going to ruin it, because it cracks so quickly. The thinner the top coat is, the smaller the cracks will be. So the heavier the application of the top coat of latex paint, the larger the cracks are. And this is a little bit heavier, so you'll probably see this crack a little bit larger. You can already see it happening in here. It cracks so quickly, especially with all these hot lights on it. It's cracking fast. But it's not sagging. I've put on a pretty thin coat of latex paint, and I'll show you over here how to brush it on. So I'm going to use a large polyester bristle brush. And because it cracks so quickly and you can't back brush too much, you really need to apply it in a crosshatch. Just little X's, that's how you're going to apply it. And it cracks along the brush stroke. So really the way you apply the top coat determines the way it cracks. I'm trying not to put this on too thick, because it's on a vertical surface and I don't want it to sag. Keep picking up the paint, cross-hatching it. Now if you find that it's really sagging as it's doing up here, you can hit it with your hog hair softener a little bit just to remove some of the paint, to stop it from sagging. You can apply a little bit more paint up there by stippling it on, but you can't do too much to it because it'll keep on cracking and you don't want to disturb it too much. When you brush it on, though, you really want to work on a horizontal surface and roll vertical surfaces. Okay, my top coat of latex paint is dry. It's all cracked. And it needs to be protected now, and I would protect it with Modern Master's Dead Flat Varnish. That's going to deaden any sheen that's on there because it's supposed to be an old look, so it needs to have a matte finish on it, and it will protect it very well. Now over here on this piece of furniture, the crackle for latex paint was done on it. It was brushed, and the base coat is an antique bronze, Modern Master's Metallic Paint Collection color. The top coat was a flat yellow latex paint. And remember that the base color that you apply is going to determine the color of your cracks. The top coat of paint that you apply is going to determine the overall color of your piece. I'm going to show you a China crackle. This crackle is great for surfaces that have previously been decorated with painted ornament or decoupage or stenciling. It looks really good on those surfaces because it's a clear crackle and you can see through it, so it makes that ornament look cracked. But whatever surface it is, it should be a sealed surface. And that's what I'm working on, is a sealed black latex semi-gloss surface. And I have Modern Masters China Crackle. It's a three-step process. There's a base coat. It's clear. You put that on and let it dry. Step two, the top coat. It's also clear. You put that on, let it dry, and the top coat cracks. You're not going to see it, though, until you do step three, and that's apply one of the enhancers. There's two different colors there, so it depends on what your base color on your surface is. So let's roll on the first coat. I've got the China Crackle base coat in here. Now it looks opaque, but it's actually going to dry clear. And you don't need a very thick coat of this on. You want to roll this out thinly, so I'm just going to take off the excess. You're going to let that dry now. And when it's dry, it's going to go clear, but it's still going to be sticky. And that's fine. It will always be sticky until you get the top coat on. Okay, the China Crackle base coat is dry. And it's ready for the top coat now. I've already got it in my pan. And I'm going to brush it on. It's much better if you brush it on than roll it on. You just get a better crackle, but you can do both. You want to load up your brush. And you have time with this to brush out and even out your brush strokes. I'm using a nice, soft polyester brush. Just apply it just like you would a varnish. So you want to get it on, get it everywhere. Then you want to even out your brush strokes. Going to take off the excess off my brush and once more in the original direction. This works best in smaller areas. It's such a delicate crackle. Now you want to leave that and let your brush strokes flow out, let it dry, and then we're ready for step three. My China Crackle top coat is dry now and it's ready for step three. That's the enhancer. There's two different colors. There's a dark enhancer and there's a light enhancer. I'm going to use the light enhancer because it's such a dark surface I'm working on. So take a rag and just dip your rag into the enhancer and work it into the cracks. You can either rub it in with a rag or you can brush it in. Just work it into the cracks and then you're going to take your rag and wipe it off the surface. And I wipe it as I go, because I don't want it to start to dry on me. Although this does have an extender in it, it's a slow drying enhancer. So you have a little bit of time to work with it. Okay, it's finished, and this is what it looks like with a light enhancer on a dark base. And here I've got a sample of what it looks like with a dark enhancer on a light base. Now this is very durable and water resistant on its own, so it doesn't have to be top coated, but for extra durability you can top coat it with Modern Masters satin varnish. Here's an example of the China Crackle on furniture. On this console table is the China Crackle with a dark base and the light enhancer rubbed into it, and it's quite a sophisticated finish. And this mirror frame was done with a light base coat and a dark enhancer rubbed in. Both finishes were applied with a spray technique.